Hi, I'm Rachel, and you're watching Bella Egypt.
Hello, welcome to another episode of Bella Egypt, coming at you from, look at this. This is winter time, not a single cloud in the sky. And coming up today in the show, what do we have? We have the same lovely lady that's been with us before. I'm not sure whether to call her Vika or Victoria or what was it? She was, sorry, I'm just scaring the guy. Scared of that. Victoria, Vicky's going to be with us today. Hey guys, as you may have guessed, we are together one more time. I would say Ashley and Vicky, but it's actually Vicky and Ashley. People tune in to see her, not me. So today we're going to continue in the gym and basically just things to work out. And you know, it's very rare that you get on a machine, and Vicky's going to go on the bike later. Even if you're biking for cardiovascular, you're also doing the tummy, so you rarely work in one muscle. But before that, what I thought would be interesting to talk about is the life of animation, because if you've never been to Egypt, till I came here, I didn't know what animation was, to tell you the truth. And when you're here, you see how much work goes into it. So run me through your day. On a normal day, what does your job involve?
Each animation, always for sure, it starts from stretching. So you make ready your body.
From what time though?
It's in each hotel it's different. It can be 10 or 10:30, sometimes even 11. Okay. You know, so it's like you get food, and after 30 minutes or 1 hour you can make stretching.
Okay, it's, all right. And don't worry if you hear noise here. We are in an active live gym. That's why you hear the noise. Okay, so you start the day stretching, 10, 11 o'clock, okay.
Yeah, then you can make some games after, yes, you can play boccia game.
What's boccia?
Boccia game is this Italian or German game with the balls, with metallic balls, yes, and you shoot through them.
Yeah. My son loves it. You get a little ball and you try to hit it.
Yeah, yeah, this is your purpose. You need to get it close.
Are you good?
Yes.
Of course you're good. She's an athlete. Even if she's not good, she stays up all night practicing. So she's good the next day. I know, I can see. And what else?
It's going to be water volleyball.
You still look like Nadia. I swear. I swear you look like Nadia.
It can be the water volley.
Water
and
volley?
And beach volley as well.
You like water volley?
Yeah. I like it. But when it's the big and strong man, a little bit scary, yes.
I tell you, you know water volley. I'll tell you a story. I'm in the Maldives, and it's the same. And these guys that want to play, they hit it so hard. They hit this poor woman on the face.
Yes.
I was so angry.
It's kind
this
of
is,
dangerous.
This is, you're on holiday.
Yeah.
It's enough to tap it. You want to show how...
Because they got too much into game, you know, they become like... they want to eat.
It's a man. They eat too much raw meat. Yeah. Yes, sorry.
And as well, this kind of game can be not on the water, yes, in beach volley.
The beach volley,
well.
Yes. And then, and then, okay, so the morning you'll go from about 10 till about what time?
Like till 1 o'clock.
1 o'clock?
Yes.
And then you relax.
Yeah, it can be also like water gym in the water.
Oh, as you well. Like water gym? That's yeah, that
yeah,
can be dancing.
It's good.
That's
yeah,
dance,
yeah, you can dance. Yes. Yes. Yeah, yeah. They can dance with you. They dance in the water, and you can dance outside the water.
Okay. So then they give you a couple of hours, so you can eat.
I should.
And
eat,
have a rest.
Relax.
And then take.
Or
it
if you want, you go to swim, or you want to go to get your tan. You know, like
yes, yes.
Up to you. If you want to sleep a little bit, it's okay as well.
Okay.
You have and a rest.
And then you're back in front of the customer. What time?
Like 3 o'clock.
3 o'clock.
3 o'clock. Be back.
And for more games.
Yeah, it also can be beach volley.
Okay.
Boccia if they would like.
Okay.
If some people, actually we have like in the morning only, but if some people would like, we always welcome, you know.
You have darts?
For now, no, but
no
actually
darts.
It's in the program.
Yeah, ping pong?
Ping pong, it's always available, not in our program, but
you
we have it.
You burn the table to stay warm,
but
right?
We have it, because we have it. Yes,
have
we have it.
As well.
Yes. And afternoon we have the dance class, we have aerobic and body toning.
Body toning?
Yes.
Body tanning.
No, toning.
Toning.
Body toning.
Ah, you know, I remember our friend Tony. Nothing to do with Tony. This
no.
is toning, which Tony Stock. That's right, our friend. We used to have a friend from England, very long hair. He's a singer from England called Tony Stock. So, okay, so you finish the day. But sometimes I see that by the buffet, I don't know if in this hotel, that also the animation are there to say hi to the people, or
yeah,
sometimes
some
they dress up because it's Mexican night or Italian night or Egyptian night.
Yeah, in some hotels and in my ex works, I get used to this. Yeah, it was my lovely night. It was when we made the superhero, my lovely part. It was because...
Don't tell me, wait. Wonder Woman.
No, I was Superwoman.
Oh, I was
super
close,
girl.
Come
no,
on.
No, Supergirl, it's called Supergirl. Supergirl.
Supergirl.
With this S as well, yes, and yeah. This was
no
my.
S.
This was my.
This was, you were Supergirl.
Yeah.
All right, then... You say you like to dance.
Yeah.
Who puts
yeah.
together the shows? Because often the animation at night also put on a show for the guests. Plus musicians come from outside. Plus maybe a tanura show comes from outside. Sometimes you have the man with the glass.
Yeah,
and they
a lot
lay
of
back
things. Yeah,
and,
a lot of things.
But who puts together the animation show for the customer? Who choreographs? Who designs?
You mean
it?
The dancing show?
Yeah.
We have our choreographers, yes, mm-hmm. we have our people who making the costumes, you know, and we say together, we practice, you know, mm-hmm. to be the same, to look good, to fix
so
the
working
hands
all day,
and the legs.
You're working, and then you're working, and then you're working, and you have to have fine time, of course,
yeah.
to practice so you don't look silly.
Yes, but if you're...
We're going to call her Supergirl from now, halas, there is no more Vicky. She is... SG.
If you are the good one and you will remember everything from the first time, you don't need to practice anymore. So
from the first time?
If second at least and
I've seen some, they don't remember from the 100th time. They go here, they go in here, they go
No,
go
but
here.
These people maybe they just, you know, beginner
they're not,
and
they're
dance.
Not dancers.
Yes,
yeah.
but
yes, yes, yes.
if you keep doing
You're a dancer,
it every
are
time.
You? Inside?
In, yes, I'm dancer inside, and now even I have some experience already because the professional people work with me.
So you're a skiing, dancing, Supergirl. We'll find the name for that.
Yes.
So skiing, dancing, Supergirl, Vicky. Do you mind showing us the machine
sure,
for today?
Sure.
Another machine for you guys to get healthy. Of course, we've all done this before, but Vicky has been very generous and said that she'll do this. How long did you say? 35 minutes?
Yes, 35 minutes, it's okay.
Okay, if you really, how long could you do this for? You have a strong heart metabolism?
Yeah, but actually, I prefer to go outside on the bicycle. This one, if you don't have time to go outside, it's very good. It will help you, yes? Like instead of bicycle. But if you have a bicycle and time, better to go outside.
When's your birthday?
14th of April.
14th of April?
Yes.
Okay. No, nothing, nowhere near mine. I'm exactly the same. I have a bike at home.
Yeah.
And I hate, just me.
You hate
it? I just hate going on these, but no. I love my bike.
Bike, because, yeah.
I'll go anywhere, I'll do just to go for 1 hour. In me,
I can go to
play
hours.
Tennis, I play any sport, I play basketball, whatever. But to sit on these, but it's just not me. But I mean, it's like we all have to do the best we can. That's
no,
right.
But it's really like you go and your environment is changing and you breathe oxygen. Oxygen.
She's a smart girl.
It's very good.
What was it? Water, landscape, air. Remember when we were trying
to find it?
Okay, one last time, guys, before we finish for the day. Bella Egypt.
On Nile TV.
It's a duo here. And I will give you the email address as well later on in the show. And Vicky will be with us. I don't know what to call you anymore. SG.
As you like.
Or
as
Super.
Like.
Or I'm going to call her As You Like, if you like. As You Like.
As You Like.
As You Like
nice
is a good
you,
name.
As well, As You Like.
Thank you, dear.
Thank you.
We'll do a
boom,
and that's it for the day. I'm out of here. Every time they keep telling me this used to be my show. Now they say leave. Bye-bye. Director, I always call him Sayed, but his name is Saeed because I always get it wrong because I'm not very smart. He has this thing about parasailing. I'm not sure why, but we will see in the next few weeks a lot of people parasailing. The ministry, according with the World Health Organization and the other organizations here in Egypt, the Middle East, came up with safety factors. It is not just washing your hands, distancing, wear a mask. That's all part of it. And we're outside most of the time anyway. But all the things that the hotel has to do to get a license to open, otherwise you close your doors. Then they give you like 30% occupancy. And they come back in a while and they don't tell you, oh, we're coming tomorrow.
They said they were going to shoot you when you came to supper.
There's nothing I can do about it.
Isn't there something I could do?
Here we go, Bella Egypt on Nile TV. That is the Facebook page. Again, one more time, Bella Egypt on Nile TV. The email is bellaegyptntv@gmail.com. Now why? Funny, we were just talking about Vicky, right, earlier on. Well, Vicky's right here saying, the people have already gone onto our Facebook page and they told me they've seen it already and we only just shot like yesterday morning, I think, or the day before. Anyway, guys, why the page? Because from this page, when the show airs, you go boom, straight up to YouTube, and then you can actually watch the show. Once you have the date on YouTube, you can go back anytime and put 3rd of March 2020, and boom, you can watch it forever and ever. But if at all possible, Sunday, 2:30, Cairo local time is the time that you can see it, and that is the real quality.
shoot you when you came to supper.
There's nothing I can do about it.
Isn't there something I could do?
Today we have a rather unusual interview, and you'll find out why in just a minute. Your name is?
Victoria.
Victoria and?
Elena.
Okay, you want me to tell the story? No, it's better, Elena. Elena speaks a little bit more English than Victoria, so we'll ask both questions, but I want Elena to explain first how long she's been here and why.
Well, it happened that we came here on 9th of March. It was just regular 9th of March.
That's the day after Ladies' Day.
Yes.
You have Ladies' Day in Ukraine?
Yes, we wanted to celebrate it here, but could not find a good package.
Okay.
Well, we came here and our intention was to stay for 4 weeks.
4 weeks.
But, you know, what happened that time and all these problems with repeating flights, with everything, we decided to stay longer. We knew that hotel is not going to be closed completely, and we won't be kicked out, so we stayed here. And
But part of the reason you wanted to stay because you couldn't go home, or you wanted to stay because you thought it was safer here than going home?
First, we did not go.
You just spoke English. I heard that. I heard. Yes, I heard. There was one word, safe. I heard.
Well, first,
we got our first Arabic word, shwai.
We did not want our vacation to be too short because they wanted to kick us out much earlier.
Yes.
First, we did not want to cut it. And then we analyzed the situation and understood that it's just a great possibility to stay here. Everything would be closed everywhere, all around the world. Mm. The planes were landed. What's the point? What's the point to come back? So we decided to stay and never. We felt very, very safe here.
Yes. And well, there was no one here. It was you in the hotel. Of course, you felt safe.
Да, в нашем любимом отеле и в Египте как в таковом.
She keeps agreeing with everything I say. I hear that at the beginning.
She says that we were absolutely happy in our favorite hotel, in a great place with a great climate, and everything was really, really, really great.
Okay, before we go on to what's been happening the last, how many times had you been to Sharm el Sheikh before?
Do we have
20 раз где-то?
She says 20 times plus, and I wanted to say if we have few minutes to calculate.
Minutes? Would be, you need a calculator? Got a calculator? Phone? Something?
It will be some big figure.
But you did explain that you came here mainly because it's just peaceful and sunny, yes?
Yes, да, конечно.
Very quiet, warm sea. Great climate, good food, everything.
But for you, the sea is always warm. I live here 23 years. I go to the local beach when the people come from Russia or Ukraine or Azerbaijan, or straight away, straight in the water. For me, it's freezing. But for
actually, it's also cold for us. But imagine, people come, for example, for a week, 10 days, 2 weeks, and what? To sit on the beach? They try to use their chance. They want
finally,
to get something.
Finally, somebody's honest. They do feel the cold, but they're here. They have to go in, otherwise they're going to go home without going in the sea.
They just want to get something, some experience, and then tell, oh, you know, it was so cold, but we jumped. It was lots of fun.
Okay, in the trips before, again, before we go on to this, you were here 20 times. Did you go out on excursions? Did you go to the desert? Did you go to safari? Or are you hotel people? Stay
and chill. Мы любим плавать. Мы занимаем, мы плаваем по 3 часа в день, если теплая вода.
We like swimming a lot. And when the water is good, we spend minimum 3 hours swimming.
3
of
hours?
Of course, yeah, it's not non-stop. No. Just like three rows.
3 hours non-stop.
Three rows, and it was really great.
Now, let's get on. Since March, okay, you stayed, your hotel, your first stay was 4 weeks. Were you deciding month by month to stay?
Yes, or? Because actually we expected that something would be more or less stable and get back to norm. Instead, you see now it's even worse.
Have they given you shares in the hotel? You're now part owner?
Unfortunately.
No shares? Nothing?
No, but
they must give you VIP status.
But we participate in ruling of the hotel.
Ah.
If something is wrong, we can say.
Mishkwai style.
Correct.
Clean.
Iva.
Mm-hmm. And of course, 9 months, it's a long time.
11.
Sounds like my school teacher at school. 11 months must have been a chance to learn, as I heard earlier, a little bit of Arabic. A few words here and there. Okay, what is tea? What is tea?
Chai.
And what is coffee?
Kava.
Ah, well, yes. What is, they know more Arabic than me.
Teacher.
What else? Good morning. I'm leaving. Here.
Halas.
Yes. Halas. All right. So we've come to the first month. The visa, I've been here 23 years. So there have been times they didn't care. Then they cared. Then they changed the rules. Of course, I'm not trying to make fun of them because then I'd get in trouble. But I mean, as far as visa, how have you managed to stay this long without having to leave? Is it because of COVID that they said, okay, we changed the rules?
Until the beginning of June, all the offices very closed. All the offices very closed, so we could not do anything about visa. Since they got open, we immediately went to Gauezet and applied for a visa. Usually it's like this, you come for a week, then you realize that not enough, then 2 weeks. We came here first time for 2 weeks and decided that it's way too little. Next, our stays were 3 weeks, and last stay here supposed to be 4 weeks. And see?
So it was you who planned Corona then, because you wanted 11 months.
We were thinking.
Wait. Subconscious, you sent a message.
We were thinking about the possibility to stay on one spot longer, because it happens that we usually really fly a lot. And it's actually tiring. Seriously, it's tiring. Children or young people have dreams about having flights very often, but in fact, when you in the system, it's very difficult. It's very difficult. So we were talking, it would be great to stay non-stop in one spot. We did not mean this very spot.
It's their fault.
It's
we found the answer.
Yeah, by the way, when this started and we were swimming in the sea, we said that perhaps at least our dream came true.
I have many messages since I've been coming out here, is Sharm safe? And I always say, is Sharm is safer than anywhere in the world I've ever been to, and safer than the UK, and I've been to South Africa, and I feel safe in Sharm, very, very safe. And the Egyptian people always make me feel welcome. So, and they're very polite. I cannot say one bad word about Sharm el-Sheikh or Egypt, because I love it, and I'm going to live here until I die.
Hi, I'm Rachel, and you're watching Bella Egypt.
I've always traveled to Abu Dhabi, Dubai. It's the part that I like, but I must say, I've decided I'm coming back for a holiday, a good holiday.
Because
I mean, here you have the sea, you have the coral reef, you have this resort, you have the mountains, you have the desert, and you're in Egypt. I mean, it's great. It's lovely to be here.
The sun and the people, they are so friendly.
I love Egypt.
Swimming, snorkeling, dolphins, dancing. Of course, I love dancing.
I've always told people, I lived in Italy for a while, that Italians, very similar in a lot of ways to Egyptians. Do you find that, or was that just me?
No, that's true, because we're almost the same, but they're Egyptian people are more and more kind. Like, they give you everything from their heart, like you just see it.